A very good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by, as you all know, today you will all appear for the practical test for the advanced part of CALC or spreadsheet. In this practical test, you will be asked many questions which you will answer by practically showing how you will do the same on your computers. Let us now get to know the rules for this test. This is a practical test for you in which you will be asked to show how you will use the options asked from you. The time for this test will be 45 minutes. For all the questions that you are asked, the answers will be shared with you by showing you videos of the correct answers. You can match your answer against this, and in case you have answered wrong, then you can learn from the videos. So let us now begin the test. All the best to all of you. Now go ahead and type in the data on your spreadsheet or create your own data. Change the name of your sheet and call it test. Show this to your teacher. Let us watch the video and see the right way of changing the name of the sheet. Watch this video now to see how you correctly have to change the name of the sheet. First, select the sheet that you want to change the name of. So we have selected sheet 1. Right click here and then choose rename sheet option. A box opens. You can use the delete button for deleting the current name and then type the name that you want. Since we want to name it test, we will type T-E-S-T, test. And then click on OK. And you will see that instead of sheet 1, now the name test appears here. This name is the test for this sheet. Now, from amongst all the entries, show how you will get the one with the highest salary and then the next highest and so on. Get this checked by your teacher. Now, all of you show how you can get the least salary from your data and then the next least and so on. Get this checked by your teacher. Let us watch the video for the correct answer and also correct our answers. Watch this video now and see if you have answered the question correctly. To find the rank, the highest salary, first, second, third rank from the data. So since we are trying to find the maximum salary, we just type that as a title and then we will apply the large formula to find the salary ranks, to find the first, second and third, the highest salary, the next highest and the next highest. So since we are going to apply the large formula, we need to first write the rank here. So let's write the title as rank in column E and then give rank 1, 2, 3. And then in the next column, let's type maximum salary. So we'll find the maximum salary here. Maximum salary. And then we apply the large formula. So for the formula, you have to type equal to large. Begin the bracket by using shift and 9. And then select the data. So the data is the salary column. So we select that data. Put a semicolon and then choose the rank. Rank 1. Select that. Close the bracket. Press enter. And you will see that the highest salary, which is 45,000, appears here. Now if you just drag down this formula, you can get rank number 2, rank number 3. So the next highest and the next highest salary will be shown here. We will now watch this video to see how we can find the least salary, the least salary, the next least and the next least. So this is the opposite of maximum salary. So we can type here as title minimum salary. Remember, you can also use the minimum formula to find the least salary. However, since we want the minimum, the least, then the second least, third least, we are going to use the small formula. So we'll type equal to small, begin bracket, select the data range, which is the salary column, select that, put a semicolon, and then since we want the least, so we are looking for the minimum rank 1. So we select rank 1 here, close the bracket, press enter, and from here, from the salary range, you can see 28,000 is the least, and that is shown here. Now if you drag this down, you will get the second least and the third least salary also from your salary data range, which is 33,000 and 45,000. So this is how you will use the small formula to find the least salary ranks. Then show how you can get the value for any one row from your data using a formula. Show this to your teacher and then watch the video for the correct answer. This video will help us understand how from lot of data we can extract one row value. So first, from this sheet we are copy pasting the titles, employee name, joining date. We just copy paste this. You can use the shortcut command or you can use the edit command here to use copy paste. On sheet 3, we have pasted the title from the test sheet. So we can just increase the column widths here so that the data appears correctly. Now from the given data of in the test sheet, we want to extract here values of one particular row. So if you want, you can take a look at the first sheet, the test sheet, and let's say we want the values of the third row, which is the student or employee name Sunil. So on sheet 3, here we will apply the H lookup formula for this. So we'll type equal to H lookup, begin the bracket, then you have to search criteria is employee name. So we will select this employee name here, A1, semicolon, and then select the array from where you want to select the data. So we obviously go back to our test sheet and select this entire data, employee name till minimum salary, all the data we select. You can see in the formula bar that this selection has been made. Then type a semicolon. Then it is the third row, so we type 3 because we want Sunil's data. Then put a semicolon, put a 0, and then close the bracket and press enter. As soon as you do this, you come back to your sheet 3 and you can see the name Sunil appears here. You can see we have applied equal to H lookup in the formula bar. You can see bracket A1 is the employee name criteria, then the range. So from test sheet we have selected that data, and third row is what we were looking for. Type is 0 and close the bracket. Now if you drag this towards the right side, you will get all the data for Sunil. Joining date, ID, salary, rank, maximum salary, minimum salary, whatever was written there in the test sheet gets brought here. So this is how you will use the H lookup to extract data for one particular row. Now show how you will use a formula to change the name of an employee. Get this checked by your teacher. Watch the video and correct your answer if required. Watch this video now to see how we use the substitute formula. So for instance, if instead of Vineet name from our data, we wanted to type actually Vinay. So we need to substitute the EET with AY. So we just put the title here, substitute, then use the formula equal to substitute, then begin the bracket, and then select the text. So the text is this one, Vineet, then put a semicolon, and which is the text that you want to replace in this? We want to replace EET, so we put that in inverted commas, put a semicolon, then type the new text that you want, again in inverted commas. So we type AY because we want to type the name Vinay instead of Vineet. So we type AY here. Put a semicolon again, and we want to do this only once, so we occurrence is only one time, so we put one here, close the bracket, press enter, and you will see that you get the name Vinay here as is being shown in the video. So this is how you will use the substitute formula to replace names in your data. Now, take up a new sheet and type out the email IDs being shown to you. Type out these 5 email IDs and then show how you can extract the first name from the email IDs. Get these checked by your teacher. Watch the video to see what is the correct method to do this. This video shows us that we can use the left formula to find the first name from the email ID. So let's go first to sheet 2 where we have these email IDs. And since we want to find the first name, we have just typed a title here as first name. Or let's apply the formula, which is equal to left, begin the bracket, and then select the text. So we select the email ID itself, semicolon, and we can count the number of characters that we want. So if we type 6 here, close the bracket, press enter, you will see that it returns PRAVEE. So we wanted to use 7 characters. So in the formula bar, we can just edit that. Instead of 6, type 7, press enter again, and you can see Praveen has come. However, if you now drag downwards and copy the same formula, what will happen is that from each of these email IDs, the first 7 characters will appear. Like you can see, Vineet dot is appearing, Pinky.5 is appearing, Sunil.2 is appearing, because there are 7 characters. So this is not correct, because we only want to find the text or the name appearing before the dot. So what we'll do, we want the first name only. So we'll use the same formula, left formula, but along with another formula which we have already learned. So we'll use left equal to left, begin bracket, then select this text, the email ID, semicolon, and then use find. And after find, use the dot to find where the dot is. Find, begin bracket, then within inverted commas, the dot, semicolon, then select the email ID again and close the bracket, and minus 1. Because we want to find the characters which are appearing before the dot. So before the dot, and then close the bracket again, press enter, and you will find that you get all the text which is appearing before the dot on the left side. So we get Praveen. Now if you drag this downwards, you will get the correct first names. So anything which is before the dot, Sunil, Pranjal, Pinky, Vineet, so all these correct first names have appeared. So this is how you're going to use the left and find formula to find the first names from your email ID. Go back to the first sheet and total the entries which have the same name and ID. Get this corrected by your teacher. Watch the video and correct your answers. Let us watch this video to understand how we will use the sum ifs formula to get the total of two same name and same ID data. So here you can see in the test sheet that all the names are different. So there is only one time that the same name is appearing. So for understanding how this is to be applied, we create another name, a sixth name or seventh name, which is also Praveen. So we type Praveen here. We also fill in the data. So we give some joining date here. So we have given a different joining date, but the ID is the same for Praveen A1. Remember, we are using two conditions. So instead of sum if, we will apply the formula for sum ifs. Now let's give a salary also for this seventh Praveen. So we are typing 30,000. And now let's apply the sum ifs formula, which will be equal to. So we are going to apply it on Praveen. So we have just typed Praveen once more. Now we will get the sum of the salaries of the same name having the same ID. So those are only Praveen have the same name, same ID. So let's see what happens. We use equal to sum ifs, begin the bracket, then the sum range is the salary column. So we select that, semicolon, and then range one is the name of the employees. So we select that, the first column, A column. Then semicolon, and the criteria is that the name should be Praveen. So we select this name Praveen, semicolon again, and then range 2 is the ID. So we select this ID column, put a semicolon again, and the criteria 2 is that the ID should be A1. So we select A1 and then close the bracket and press enter. So you will see that since Praveen, both the salaries, one first, the second number name Praveen at in row 2 is 38,000 and the seventh row has 30,000. The total is 68,000. So you get the total 68,000 here by using the sum ifs formula. So this is how you will use this to get the sum for any data with the same name and same ID using two conditions and using sum ifs. Now go back to the second sheet and show how you can extract the last part from the email IDs like .org, .in, .com, etc. Show these also to your teacher. Watch the video and check your answers against it, and then also correct your answers. Watch this video carefully to learn how the right formula is used to find the last name from an email ID. Let's select sheet 2 where we have the email IDs, and in the last name column we are going to find the last name. So we can use the formulas here. We'll type equal to, we will be using the right formula now. First we were using left formula for the first name. Now since we want to find the last name, which is like com or in after the dot, we'll use the right formula. From the right side we are counting. So right equal to right, begin bracket, then select the text, which is the email ID, semicolon. Then we will get the length. We will use the length formula, LEN within bracket, and we will count the length of this entire email ID. So we select the email ID, close the bracket here, then minus find, begin the bracket, and the text is the email ID. So we select that. First we write the what we want to find is the dot. So we put the dot in inverted commas, semicolon, and then we select the text, which is the email ID itself, semicolon, and find again, because now we are going to find from the dot till at the rate from the right side, and then find begin bracket within inverted commas, we are writing at the rate, semicolon again, select the text, which is the email ID, and then close these three brackets which we had opened. Put three brackets to close. When you press enter, you will find com is written. This is happening because we have found the text which is between at the rate and the last dot, and then just given the text which is after the last dot. So when you drag this down to apply the formula for all the email IDs, you get com, com, in, com, and in. So this is the formula which you will use for doing this from the right side. If you want to find like the last name or the last text which appears after the dot. Again, go back to sheet 1 and count those names which have the same name and ID. Get it checked from your teacher. Watch the video for the correct method and correct your answers. This video now tells us how we are going to use the COUNTIFS formula to count the number of times the same name having the same ID is appearing in our data. So for this, we are going to use the COUNTIFS formula equal to COUNTIFS, begin the bracket, then the range 1 is the employee names, so we select the employee names, semicolon, and then criteria, we select Praveen because that's the name that we want to count appearing how many times. Then the next range, range 2, is the ID range, so we select that, semicolon, and then select the criteria 2, which is the A1 ID for Praveen, close the bracket, and when you press enter, you can see that this occurs 2 times. The same name having the same ID is appearing in this data 2 times. So this is how you will use the COUNTIFS formula. Going back to the second sheet, extract the middle part from the email IDs beginning from the @ symbol until .org or .in, etc. Show this also to your teacher. Let's watch the video and learn this and also cross-check your own answers. Watch this video also very carefully to see how we use the mid formula along with find formula to find the mid name. So now we go to sheet 2 and we are trying to find the mid name. The mid name is after @ and the second dot which is appearing. So anything like Gmail, Yahoo, Hotmail, that is the mid name that we are trying to find. So let's key in the formula equal to mid begin bracket, then select the text from where we want to find the mid name. So that will be the email ID, semicolon, and then we find. We use find begin bracket, then within inverted commas we are going to type @ because we want to find after @ semicolon, again email ID is the text from where we are wanting to find this @ symbol, close the bracket, and then let's do +1 because we are going to look for text after the @ symbol, semicolon, and then find once again. Now we are going to find the dot. So find begin bracket, put the dot within inverted commas. So we do that, semicolon, then the text is again the email ID. So we select that. Once again, semicolon, and we are going to find once again the @ symbol. So find begin bracket within inverted commas @ symbol, because what we are trying to do is from @ till the last dot, we want to find the mid name in between that. Select the text, which is the email ID. So we've selected that, close the bracket one more time. And then minus, and one more time we'll use find, because we are going to just find between these two @ symbol and the dot. So find, one more time we'll be finding @ symbol. So we put that in inverted commas, semicolon, then A2, which is the email ID, close the bracket, minus 1, and then we need to close the brackets again. So you should remember how this is being done, and then you press enter. You will see that the text appearing as a mid name between @ and till dot, that appears here like Gmail. So look, let's look at the formula once again. Mid, then bracket, then you type, select the email ID as the name, and then find @, put in inverted commas. Again, since it is from email ID, then plus 1, because we want to find after the @ symbol. Then find again, this time we are looking for dot from the email ID. So we type that, and then semicolon, find @ once again from the email ID, minus find @, then the email ID from the email ID, and minus 1. So this is how you get Gmail. If you drag this down, you will get the mid name from all of these email IDs, which is Gmail, Gmail, Yahoo, Hotmail, and Yahoo. So this is an important formula. This is an important function that you should remember how it has been used. You can look at the formula once again and note this for future use. So this is how you will use the mid name and the find formula to find the mid name from your any given email IDs in your Calci sheet. Come to sheet 1 again. You have 3 numbers, 5, 4 and 3, the total of which is 12. Now show how you will use an option which will help you make this target value as 15. Get this checked by your teacher. Watch the video and check your answers. Watch this video now to see how we use the goal seek option from the tools menu to get the target value for numbers which are given as our data. So we select this test sheet and we type in the numbers here first. So the numbers we want to type are 5, 3 and 3. Let's type it below this number title here. So we'll type 5, not 4, 5, 3 and 3. And then we can get the total of these numbers. By using the sum formula, we can get the total. So we'll use the sum formula here, equal to sum, and then select these numbers within the bracket. Close the bracket and then press enter. You get the total as 11. However, our target value that we want is 15. So we can type the target value here, target. and then we type 15 here. So we want to apply this goal seek formula on the total cell. So we'll select the total cell where 11 is written and then go to the tools menu, select this total cell, go to the tools menu and apply the goal seek formula here so that this total becomes 15 instead of 11. So from the tools menu, select goal seek, box appears, your formula cell has already been selected as the total cell. The target value is what you need to type in here, which is 15. So we type the target value 15 and we select one of the cells as the variable cell so that we can change the value of that particular cell. So we have to make a selection. So we select the cell 3, where the value is 3. We select that cell and then click on OK for goal seek. It shows us that goal seek has been successful and we can click on yes, and you see that instead of 3, this figure has been changed to 7 so that the total is 15, which is also the target value. So this is how you will use the goal seek formula. Going back to the second sheet, show how you will apply scenario on any row and column. Use the name test 1 and test 2 for these scenarios. After doing this, get it checked by your teacher. Correct your answer after comparing it to the video. Watch this video now and let's see how we can apply scenario to our data with a given name. So let's first select the sheet 2. We can copy paste some data. So we are copying these first names here, or we can go to another sheet, test sheet, and let's copy the employee name as the data that we are going to use and paste it on sheet 2 here. So we've copied the employee name here and we are going to apply the scenario on this data. So we select this data again, employee name, select this data, then go to tools menu, click on that and click on the scenario option. A box appears for scenarios and you can change the name. Test 1 is what the name we want to give this scenario, and click on OK. So as soon as you click on OK, you will see that a border appears and a drop down button appears on this data. So this has now become our scenario, first scenario. Now let's use some other data also and apply the second scenario. So we can just delete this, select this and delete this. However, this data is still applied. So we go to tools, go to scenario and apply the second scenario and name that as test 2. So we click on OK and the second scenario has also been applied here. We can delete this data here by selecting, go back to test sheet and select the salary data, salary column, go to sheet 2 and apply that here, paste it here. So we have the salary. Now there are two scenarios which have been applied here. When you click on the drop down button, you see test 1, which is the salary data, and employee name data. So you can see all the employee names. Click on test 2 and you can see the salary data. So this is how you can apply the salary data and the names data, employee names data, as two scenarios on the same location. On the first sheet, show how you will get the average for all those entries whose name and ID are the same. Get these also checked by your teacher. Watch the video to know the correct answer. Let's watch this video to see how we can use the average ifs formula to find the average salary of a person with the same name and the same ID. So since there are two conditions we are applying, we are using the average ifs formula. So there are two names which are the same, Praveen, and their ID is also the same, A1. So we are going to find the average salary for both these names. So we use average ifs formula equal to average ifs, begin bracket, then choose the average range. So since we are trying to find the salary average range, we are going to select the salary column or the salary detail. So that's the range, average range, from where we want to find the average. Then the criteria one is the name Praveen. Is the names, employee names. So we select that and then enter the criteria, which is Praveen. Next, we select the range two, which is the ID range. And the criteria is A1, because Praveen, the name appears at two places with the same ID, A1. Then we close the bracket and press enter, and you will find that the average salary for the two Praveens or the two salaries that are there, 38,000 and 30,000, the average of which is 34,000, gets shown to us. So we can see 38,000, 30,000 for the same name Praveen, with the ID also being the same. Show how you will create the pivot table. Remember that you must count all the values. Have your teacher check your answer. Correct your answer with the help of the video. Let us now watch this video and understand how we can create the pivot table for our data. So first of all, we have selected this data as is being shown in the video, and we go to sheet 3 and paste that data here. So we have employee name, joining date, ID and salary. Now we have already selected this data, so we can go to the data menu, click there, click on the pivot table and create. Click on the create option, and since we have already selected the current selection, click on OK. Now the pivot table layout is given. So we first, you want to use the employees, we want to bring them in the rows field. So we bring it here as is being shown in the video. Next is the joining date. Next, we take the salary to the data fields. Similarly, the joining date we take to the page fields and the ID to the column fields, and then click on OK. So this will create the pivot table here with all these fields. And you can see that there are these drop down buttons which you can use to access data that you want. So if you click on the drop down button for employee name, and if you click on any one of them you want to see, we have just selected Pinky's name, click on OK, and then you can see the details of Pinky. So the salary is shown, the total salary is shown. Similarly, if you click by the ID or joining date, you can see all the details of people who have joined on that particular date. If you select all the IDs or a specific ID, you can see their details here also. With the joining date, you can select any one of these joining dates or all the joining dates and see all the data which is relevant for that joining date. So this way you can create the pivot table and use it for extracting information from a large amount of data. Next, using the numbers being shown to you, show how you will apply the PMT, the PV, and the IPMT formulas. Take the rate equal to 5%, number of months as 12, and money 5,000. First, find the PMT. Get it checked by the teacher. Watch the video and correct your answer. Let's watch this video and see how we can use the PMT formula to calculate the monthly payments for an amount. So firstly, we go to one of these sheets, let's say sheet 2, as is being shown in the video, and we key in the data that we already have. We know the rate, we know the time period, which is in months, and we also know the amount. So we will just type these. For the amount, we need to, in this cell, when we are typing, we want to first also define the currency. So we do we click on this cell and then we go to format cell and we can select the currency from here. Since we want to be use Indian rupees, we will select the INR or Indian rupee currency. You can scroll up and down and get to INR. You can use this drop down button, select INR, click on OK. So any amount that you type will come in Indian rupee. So let's first try with 500 or 50 rupees. So we're just typing 50. This is an Indian rupee, INR. Then the rate we know is 5%. So we type 5%. And months, we have 12 months. Now we want to find the monthly payments for this amount. So we use the PMT formula. So we use it as equal to PMT, begin the bracket, then the rate we select from here, 5%, and since we want to make it monthly, we divide by 12, then put a semicolon, and then the number of months, so we select that, put a semicolon, and the present value, which is 50, and then the type is 1, semicolon 0, close the bracket, press enter, so it shows you 4.36. So the monthly amount is 4.36 rupees. If you see here, it is showing as dollars. So we can again go to format cell and select the currency to be Indian rupee. Click on OK. Then it shows 4.36 Indian rupees. We can see this once again. We've used PMT formula, which is equal to PMT begin bracket. Then the rate, we select the rate 5% divided by 12, semicolon, then the time period, which is 12 months, semicolon, and the present value, which is 50 INR, we select that, and then the type is 1, semicolon 0, close the bracket. When you press enter, you will see 4.36 Indian rupees. Now, if you want to change the amount and know the monthly payment for that, you can just simply change the amount and the PMT will be automatically calculated. So, if instead of 50, you can go to the formula bar and edit it here, you can make it 500 or you can make it 5000 as is being shown in this video. And the rest is the same. So, you see the amount here now for 5000 is 428 rupees and 12 paisa. You have finished your test. Save your file in the documents folder with your name and today's date as the file name. Now you have completed your learning of the advanced part also. Now you will next appear for a written test, after which Computer Shiksha will award you certificates of completion. We thank you all for patiently and carefully learning about this advanced part and wish you all the very best. Thank you.